We're back on gas, mowing, and landscaping. If you guys don't know, this is the landscaping and mowing series that we're building, and we're still, like I say, we're building it. It's like half done. Our whole yard and headquarters is like half done. We got a ways to go, but something came across the classifieds, which is a cat skid loader. And so I think I'm going to go pick this up. It's going to be pretty crazy. I had this mod FS17. We're going to get it for FS19. Now, I mentioned a couple videos ago, Ross Williams, he has a Farmfluencer video. Basically, all you do is go to Farmfluencer and you vote and you click the vote button. And the contest ends in a couple days. And if he's in the top two spots, he wins a big prize. Hood, please go vote for him. He's a fellow farming simulator modder. So he's helped out the community a lot. So while we're going, I'm going to get this off. I'm going to get the GS45 off. That's going to start up. That's going to take a while to warm up and start up. And we're going to yank that off the truck. And then I'm going to actually take the Chevy 4500 to go pick up this skid loader if I like it. And the guy also said he had a Case garden tractor in the garage. And I may go pick that up too because I thought, heck, that might be good for us. So, like, we're getting loaded with equipment and we're not even done yet. I don't know. It's just super fun going picking up equipment. Let me get the GS45 off. By the way, guys, if you haven't seen Squad Farms lately, we have a new YouTuber on there. That's Stevio. He's doing a fantastic job. I'll link his first video down below if you want to go check it out. But he was probably one of the best farming simulator players I've ever seen. It's insanely good. He plays farming really realistically, and he's completely different than me.
We have a $2 million loan that we'll have to pay off. So come join us as we tackle this loan and grow our farm up here in Ohio.
It's like really relaxing to watch him. I'm crazy. I'm all over the place. Go check him out. If you guys want and you're interested in farming, you can even subscribe. But he's going to be posting pretty much daily, maybe only 6 days a week on there. Does a fantastic job. Just go check it out. I'll have the link down below. So I'm going to fire up the Chevy 4500. We're going to fold her up. Now, a lot of you guys say this ramp looks horrible. I agree. I think somebody might have made an edit, and I got to pick up that edit if somebody did. Yeah, it does. You guys are right. It does look pretty darn bad. I wish it was kind of shorter. Nope. Something maybe like a fold up ramp would be a lot better. That'd be perfect. And then also, I plan on building. So there's these buildings that you can buy. Check these out. Okay, so I was going to buy something like these. Maybe like a vehicle shelter, something like that. It's kind of old school, and I don't know if it'll really match our building we have now. But we could put like skid loaders and attachments under these. It'd be kind of nice, like drive-through shelter. That would be pretty good. These are kind of small shelters, but they would work. Anyways, when you put these up, like you place it down, okay, and it has the building materials. And then you have to walk over to it, and it builds itself. It's pretty cool. You hear all these drills going and stuff. It's really cool. So it's like a really, it's a whole new aspect of farming simulator. And it's pretty crazy. So I found this on Mod Hub. So we're going to hit the road. We have about a 2 hour drive. It's going to be about dark. I'm going to try to really step on her. Maybe do some illegal activities and go over the speed limit just a tad bit. We'll try to get there in like an hour and a half or hour. Okay, we made it. Okay, I don't even want to tell you guys how fast I was going. So this is actually like right where we started out. There was our old shop, and I kind of knew this guy. He was an old retired guy. He just loved his equipment. He always did like really small tasks for people. Almost had like a really tiny, like almost like a friendly / family landscaping business. I mean, he only did work for people he knew, and he just kind of helped them out with his equipment. He just loved his equipment. And so he told me to come over and take a look at the equipment. I know the price. He knows the price. If I want it for his price, he said he's firm on the price for his skid loader. His skid loader is not bad. It has 1,100 hours. He's asking 43 grand for it, which isn't a bad price. And it comes with these two attachments. The Cat 289D. This is pretty crazy. And by the way, I got to say, Hunter from External's Mind, thank you for converting this. All he did is convert it, and he didn't do any work to it. It'd be cool. He was like, I don't know if he's going to UDIM it or do any more work to it. I have no idea. But Kyle, the guy that made the Bobcats, I was thinking, oh, that'd be sweet if Kyle took over the project. I'm not sure what Hunter's plan is with this skid loader, but it's pretty darn solid for just converting it. He said there's probably a lot of errors with it, so we're kind of testing it out. I haven't really used it much. I know it works and it runs, but we'll see how the mod does. But so I mean, 43k, not bad for this skid loader. This is like a $5,000 brush hog, and it came with it. It's a Cat brush hog that goes on the front. I know the hydraulics aren't connected all the way. It'd be cool if they did go up all the way. But this was made by Iconic too. Thanks Iconic for making this. And then we got the CSM, a really long orcs that come with it. So I was like, yeah, we'll do her. It's got the Bobcat logo. Those will be perfect for the Bobcats. And then it comes with the big techs. But the thing is, this guy also has his garden tractor for sale too. I didn't know this until I called him. He was like, hey, would you want the garden tractor at all? Like, okay, I mean, yeah, maybe we'll take her. So I got to see, but he's asking $8,000 for this, which I don't know if that's steep or not. I got to kind of do some research with all the attachments. It's not bad. Thing is, can I haul all of this back today? If I'm getting this, I don't want to make another trip out here. I want to haul it all back today. This would be nice. I feel like we have way too much equipment though. So he said, test her out, run her, see what you like of her. So fired her up. Gonna lift up the bush hog. Hydraulics are solid. Heck, we'll lift it. We'll see how high it reaches as long as we don't put a hole in the ceiling. Okay, should I turn it? This probably isn't safe, but I'm gonna turn the bush hog on. Hydraulics work. Bush hog works. Let's turn her off. Nice. Okay. Dude, I'm gonna go. Okay, I don't know if he has any land here, if this is his neighbor's land, but I wouldn't mind just going out here and just mowing, testing this thing out. So far, it controls real good, but the thing is with skid loaders and farm sim, is you gotta see how they do when they go on trailers. The skid loaders are really weird when they go on hills and trailers and farm sim. Kyle kind of fixed that with his Bobcat, but I wonder how this skid loader is gonna be. I'm gonna turn her on. One thing I noticed is you can't, like here, it's all the way down on the ground, and I can't like curl it anymore. So it's kind of at a weird angle. Like I can't curl it back anymore. It's as far back as it goes. So when you drop it down, I think it'll do good. So let me turn on the blades. By the way, guys, thank you for liking the videos. And if you guys enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate if you guys like it. It means so much. It honestly helps out the YouTube algorithm a lot, it seems like. So it just, and it helps out me a ton. So I really appreciate it, guys. Thank you. Dude, this is sweet. Okay, imagine like once we get the crew, we get Spencer, we get artists, we get a couple other guys. And I have, let's see, we have this. Well, if I purchase this, we'll have this skid loader. We'll have two other skid loaders. And then we go like clear out a forest, clear all the trees in a forest, and then like mow it all down. This could be pretty cool. That works. I'm kind of digging this cat 289D. This is like the cat's meow, dude. No pun. Okay, there was kind of a pun intended there, but seriously, if I got a skid loader in real life, I feel like I'd have to go a cat skid loader. The branding that's with them, the cat construction. I don't know. I feel like you gotta, but who knows? Everybody likes their different types of equipment. Okay. We might have to get this thing. Oh, man. And then here's the case. I could fire her up for you guys. Well, I guess mainly for me. Fires right up. What the heck? Okay, so the deck discharges out the left. Have you guys ever seen that in real life? I'm pretty sure every mower I've seen in like driven in real life always discharges out the right side. Maybe this deck's like backwards on it or something. I've never seen anything discharge out the left side. I could be wrong though. Could be wrong. Okay, let's see how this mows. You know what? It's got a PTO in the back too, so we could put like a bush hog. It's got, dude, should I use this? I wonder how that would work. I actually really want to use that tiller right now. I don't know if he's going to allow us to test it out. Okay, I'm really curious to test out this tiller, so I'm gonna drop the deck here. Just hit Q, drop the deck. It should be drive over. Oh gosh, maybe backwards. There we go. Okay, I gotta kind of slide this deck forward. Just grab onto her. There we go. Perfect. Okay, so I'm gonna connect the tiller. Now let's see how this works, because this would actually be perfect for tilling gardens. We have a lot of customers, and if we're like redoing a lawn, this would work really good. Just have a tiller on the back. Tilt the lawn. I'm so excited to actually do some like jobs now. We got like crazy equipment. If we get this, we'll have like crazy equipment. It'll be fun. Right there, it's got a 3-point and attach. Nice. I wonder if I need weights in the front. Oh shoot. Here we go. Okay, I'm just gonna I don't know if this is his land or not. I'm just gonna drop her down right here. We'll see if this how good this works. Okay, so allow create a field. Yes. Turn on cultivator. Yes. Oh, the animations with this too. The shaking of the PTL. Okay, here we go. Drop her down. Solid, dude. Look at that. Okay, I know it's really dangerous to jump out, but I'm going to do it anyways. That's pretty neat. I'm going to turn the blades off. And that does really good. Like, say we're creating food plots for a customer, gardens for customers. We could really use this. And I don't have anything that'll till up gardens yet. Unless I could probably get an attachment for the skid loader. That'd work pretty good if I got an attachment for a skid loader. Or if we got a utility tractor someday, like, bigger than this. But I think I got to take this tractor. I think this would be good. So he was pretty much firm on the price of $8,000 for the tractor and all attachments, and then $43,000 for the skid loader and all the attachments. But he had some trailers. He was like, I'll toss in the big techs with it if we do 52. And I'm like, man, because it'd technically be 51,000 for the skid loader and tractor. So basically he dropped his price a ton for me. And after we started negotiating, so 52 with the big tech trailer, and that's an expensive trailer. But then he had this landscape trailer back here. And I was like, oh man, I was trying to figure out if I need it, first of all. I know he wants to sell this because he's trying to get rid of everything pretty much, moving down to Florida. And so then he was like, let's go 54 and I'll toss in the landscape trailer. I'm like, man, you're making it too good. Because with 51 for that, he's technically saying the landscape trailer is worth $3,000. That's a pretty darn good deal for a trailer like this. And this, I don't know if the garden tractor could get in it, or like we could haul with the garden tractor. It'd be perfect for the mowers though. I probably could fit the garden tractor in there. Thing is I'd probably have to come back for this trailer. That'd be fine. It'd be sweet to get an enclosed trailer. Don't get me wrong. I think we're going to do it. So $54,000. I gave him the cash. $54,000. Okay, we need to start making some money now. And by the way, I gave him the money. It's just my account is so large up there. It didn't even go down from where it's at because we have way more money than is actual up there. We have a crazy amount of money. Anyways, eventually, once we get all of our equipment, I'm going to reset that money to like $50,000 or something kind of realistic. And then we'll go from there. So each job we do, we'll get like, you know, $50 for a lawn mowed or something, and it'll just add to the account. But until I get all my equipment bought, I'm just basically having infinite money. Okay, so I think I could honestly get everything fitted on this trailer. And in the back of the truck, since we got room in the back of the truck, like the garden tractor may be able to fit back there. We're going to load down this truck. This is going to be interesting. I don't know how this is going to work, but I think I can get it to work. And then I'll have an empty trailer I can come back to. I want to see if I can get everything loaded in this truck. This will be pretty crazy. And then we'll bring her back to the shop. I'm going to lift that up. So the first thing is, let's load in the back of this truck. Whatever we're going to load in the back of the truck, let's do it now. So, the garden tractor. I don't think I can fit the skid loader in there. I don't want to, because I'd be way overloaded. I'm going to put the garden tractor in there with as many attachments as possible. So, like, we'll keep this tiller on the back. Did I call it cultivator? Tiller, cultivator. And then I'm going to connect... Should we connect the loader? Yeah, we'll connect the loader to it. Or actually, I might not be able to fit with the loader on it. So for now, I'm just going to go these two. We can fit the loader and that blade on the trailer, probably. Okay. Now, in real life, I think the deck is most likely going to bottom out. We'll see how it goes up this. But in real life, I bet the deck would bottom out on this. Come on. Okay, maybe we're going to have to leave the deck behind. We may have to leave this deck behind. I don't think I can get it up with the deck. So I'll put the deck on... We'll put the deck on the big techs. That should work out good. Okay. Let's see if this works. We're bopping wheelies. Oh, shoot, dude. What is that? There we go. Nice. Smooth. Okay, will this fit, though? It just barely fits. Perfect. Okay, we got that up there. I'm going to fold the ramps. I know these are ugly ramps. It'd be cool if these ramps actually just folded in half. That'd be nice for this. So now I'm going to connect to the big techs. We got to fit all those attachments on, and then the skid loader and skid loader attachments. We are connected. I know it's a little weird, but we are connected. Dude, this Duramax is going to be hauling a lot. I'm gonna unfold that. Perfect. Man, the lighting right now just looks so good on this truck. The one thing is, we have all black trailers, and this one's silver. It came with a package deal, so I was like, I didn't really want it because it was silver, but we have all black trailers, so we may have to toss some paint on this. Get her painted all black. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna put on is this bush hog. I'm just gonna put it right towards the front. All of our attachments will be towards the front, and the skid loader will most likely be more towards the back. There we go. Let's see how this works. Okay, that dropped off. Let's strap that down. There we go. We'll just put 3 straps on it. Perfect. Okay, so now I'm going to use the forks to put all those other garden tractor attachments on there, because I don't think I can lift those just straight on the trailer. Okay, I kind of got these on there. I know it's like super unrealistic right now with that mower deck, how it's going through there. I hope these strap down. I think they do. I'm pretty sure these strap down, so we should be good. I'm going to just slowly go up here, then we'll tilt it, and I may have to just kind of get out of the skid loader and just push it off. There we go. Okay, I'm going to try pushing this blade off. Just give it a little push. Just kind of, there we go. Push it on there. Does that strap down? Oh, it doesn't. Wait. Okay, oh, the fork strapped down. Okay. Maybe the deck will strap down? Okay, so I couldn't get those to strap down, so I asked the guy, can I just leave them here? He's like, yeah, come pick them up tomorrow. So we're just going to leave those attachments here. We'll come up, pick up this trailer tomorrow, and I'm going to shut his doors. And then all we have to do is load this skid loader up. We're hitting the road. It's still a really heavy load. I can get this strapped down too. I don't think now. Oh, shoot. Oh, here's the moment of truth. Will the skid loader climb these little ramps? I think it's going to have a tough time climbing it. We'll see though. Now the skid loader doesn't strap down, but the forks do. So we should be fine, because I'll just leave the forks attached to the skid loader. Oh, perfect, man. Honor, nice job on this. He said he didn't even mess with anything on FS19. And wow, that climbs better than the in-game stuff. That's crazy. So right there, perfect. And then these should kind of help. There we go. Perfect. That'll help strap down the skid loader. Ready, rock and roll, dude. I need a bucket yet for this, so maybe we'll stop and pick up a bucket. That'd be nice for this. We're going to be driving through night, though. Hold those up. We got a lot of weight on behind this Chevy. This Duramax looks clean, though, dude. So I'll probably see you guys. It'll be like midnight. I'll actually probably see you guys in the morning once we get back, because right when I get back, I'm heading to bed, and I'll talk to you guys in the morning. Oh, man, I got back late last night, parked the truck, and just left it right there. Now, I was thinking, I was having some dreams about this like nice big shop of ours that we could have out here. Don't get me wrong, we have a big shop now, but we're under an issue of we have way too much equipment. Guess whose fault that is? Of course, mine. But we're going to need for sure another building, and it could be just more of a storage building. And so there's a couple smaller sheds I've been thinking about going with. Now, okay, a couple ideas. This is a vehicle shelter. So, this would be perfect. It's kind of small, but I feel like if I place like 2 of these out here, just like here and here, this would be perfect for skid loaders or just parking trucks underneath here. Trucks would be perfect. Trailers are probably going to have to sit outside, don't get me wrong. And then skid loaders and stuff could sit in here. But also, I've been also thinking about getting... Let's see, our building is white, so we probably want to stay with the theme of white, right? So, we'll go with like something like this. I know this is a really small shed, but this would work good. It's got, I think this would work good, at least. Collides with an object. What object does it collide with? Maybe something bigger. That does look really darn small. So that's a 52 by 72 building. I guess the only other thing we could go with, and this would just get like... humongous. Actually, that doesn't even look that big either. How big is this thing? Okay, maybe our trailers could fit in here. That wouldn't be a bad idea. Just putting our trailers and maybe even trucks in here. Okay, we're going to start out with a small building. If it's too small, I'll tear it down. I'll get a bigger building. So I can either go 40 by... Here's a 40 by 60. Okay, that is a small building. Let's go 52 by 72, a white building. Now, do I want it to the side? Could have it to the side like this. I think I want it this way. We're going to put it like this, and then I can build kind of like a dirt road out to it. That'd be actually really neat. So like right here. Okay, I'm going to raise it up a little bit. So I got this building place down, and what I did also, since we were kind of landscaping, and I was actually inspired by Stevio. If you guys don't remember at the start of the video, Stevio runs Squad Farms now, but he makes some crazy maps. Like he'll make it, or not crazy maps, but crazy farm. Like he'll design his farm with a landscape tool. And so I just spent like 15 minutes working on this. But what we have here is kind of a burn pile to the back of the grove, almost back behind these buildings. I made a little driveway here. I'll take you guys down it. What do we want to take? I want to take this old Chevy. We'll take the old Chevy. I gotta disconnect the trailer. There we go. But I'll show you guys this. It's kind of like a dirt trail through here to the back. And then there's a spot cleared out for like a burn pile. So if we have brush we need to bring back, I'll just put it back through here. Kind of nice. There's this old trail that comes through here. You gotta go under a couple trees. Hopefully this grass really grows in. That'll be neat. And then there's the field. But then you come out to this burn pile spot. And so this is where the burn pile is going to be. I may kind of want to clear out some more trees around here. And then there's the field. But this is where the burn pile is going to be. Kind of like the dump pile. That's hidden behind everything where we put like our bushes, our dead bushes. And we have a big fire here. So that's kind of the spot right here we got going. There's the shop up front. We got that building up there. And then now I don't know if I want to put these up. It'll be cool putting them up. But I don't know how useful they're going to be. I'm going to try them out. It's not going to look the clean. These are kind of like older farm buildings, I guess. But I'm going to try putting them up. Come out through here. Through the road. There we go. So if we get a dump trailer, that'd be kind of cool. Because I can dump off like branches and stuff back there. I kind of got my trucks all over the place. I know. So here, I was going to put these buildings down. We can try it. I think it'll be kind of neat. I want to make this a big complex. But what we're going to do is, I was even on the wrong thing. So I'm going to go to sheds. Something like a vehicle shelter. So something like this is what I want to put down. I gotta test one out to make sure it works the way I want to. I guess I could just sell it. So I'm going to put one. We'll put a little dirt around it. There we go. I want to put just a tad bit of dirt around it. And we're going to build this up. This is actually really cool. Just kind of make it a little more dirty around there. There we go. Move around to this side. I'm going to add some dirt around the edging. I guess I could do some crazy landscaping too. Okay, there we go. And then now, oh shoot. I may have built this the wrong way. I can't tell what way it's facing. I'm assuming this might go the wrong way. Okay, we'll see. I could always sell it. So, what you do is you just hit build. How is this not destroying my game right now? Yep, we built it the wrong way. That's so cool though. Okay, this will actually work really good. So, like I said, it doesn't really go along the best with the buildings, but it'll be kind of cool. So I got to figure out and I got to sell this and we got to put it the other way. I really screwed up there, but that was really cool because we got to do it again now. Okay, so here she goes. I have it placed the correct way. Oh, dude, look at it. And this is actually a lot bigger than I expected too. This is neat. How does one even mod something like that? There we go. That's going to work good. Does it have lights? It has lights. No way. Okay. So like our trucks, we'll probably just put in there. I'm going to get rid of some of this grass. We'll probably just put in a little dirt there. I'm thinking about building another one. It's kind of like, I don't know, European though. That's the only thing I'm not really, because this is kind of supposed to be American map. So it's the only thing I'm not like really liking that much about this. Probably put dirt off of here. There we go. Dirt all this. And then we'll just act kind of like it's on a hill. And then like even like landscaping materials could just go in there. That'd look good. I'm thinking about putting one more up. If I do, let's just put it up now. Yeah, let's put one more. So here's my next one. And then in between here could be trailer parking. Could be different truck parking. We'll see. is it to, it looks pretty straight. Okay, I was making sure it was lined up good with that one. We'll just have this like kind of be mud. I should have it be gravel. It's complete. There we go. Okay, so a little bit, I'm gonna stick with mud for now. We could kind of change this later though. We don't have to go that thick with the mud. It's supposed to be kind of dirt too. Little weeds in there. We can kind of always clean that up later. This is more of like, I don't know. We'll, and then through there could be parking. Now out here's probably gonna have to be trailer parking if we want to put trailers in there. But here's trucks. We could put anything in there. The only thing is like anybody can get into it. Anybody can break into that building. So maybe we won't put the nicest stuff in there. I don't know. We gotta have, and then I gotta put trees all around here to kind of finish out this grove. Okay, it's not looking too bad. So I outlined that with those spruce trees, the medium spruce trees. Those look good. And then I have trees all the way around back here. We could put some cool designs throughout here. And then this is the landscaping yard. The thing about these is they do look a little, I don't know, they don't look they don't look like truly American. It's fine though. It'll work good. I like the lights in them though. We got that building, and then if we later need to expand, we can expand. It's a little different. I went with like a little different look, but I think it's going to be good. We'll have to put, and then this could be like trailer parking. Like trucks and trailers could be parked back here. We have to get organized though, like really badly. And then there's that burnt pile back there. But guys, this is going to be the end of the video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy it. If you did, hit that like button. Also, don't forget to check out Stevio over on Squad Farms. Thanks for watching, guys.